I was a huge horror movie fan when I was like 18, 19. Freddy Krueger, Jason. I kind of grew out of like slasher movies. And then I started to get into Hellraiser, Clive Barker. They weren't slasher movies. It wasn't, you know, about some crazy killer going out killing people. What happened was I was really fascinated with the makeup effects.
Yeah.
I thought for a while that I wanted to do that. It was like I wanted to get into, like, you know, making cool makeup effects and stuff.
Like a Tom Savini or something?
Yeah, yeah. I remember I had Tom Savini's book, and I read that. I was like, this would be a really cool job to have. I couldn't look at real stuff. Like, real stuff, I was like, ugh, I couldn't take it. But if it was fake, I was, like, into it. You know what I mean?
Mm-hmm.
Saw movies are, like, really popular. I can't really get into them.
I've never watched one of them.
What do they call it? Torture porn.
Well, I know where that fucking started. Goddamn fucking I Spit on Your Grave. Fuck that motherfucking movie. I hate it.
I don't like women giving me orders.
I Spit on Your Grave.
Now, see, I liked I Spit on Your Grave.
I hate that movie.
I did like it because I knew that even though this poor woman went through... I'm talking about the original one.
It was
dude, it was hardcore, the shit that they did to this poor woman. And this actress, I hope she got paid a lot of money. She probably didn't. She went through a ton of shit. And I knew that she was going to get those guys back. And that's one reason that kept me into it.
Oh, she got them great.
God bless your hands.
Wait till you feel this.
Oh, yeah, that's fantastic.
No. No, not that.
I Spit on Your Grave.
It's too cruel. You gotta have just a little hope. I mean, that's how I feel about the Rob Zombie Halloween movies, too. It's like, they're done technically very well, but they fucking feel hopeless, man. It's like being an Oakland A's fan. After a while, it's like, okay, I've had it! I'm getting the fuck out of here!
Favorite horror movies? I can think of horror movies that, if they're on, I have to watch them.
Yeah.
Like, The Shining. I love that movie. Just everything about it. The Thing, I think, is fantastic. I feel like my favorite horror movies are not really... I don't really consider them horror movies. Most recently, I want to say in like the past year, I want to say my favorite horror films in the past year. I liked Smile a lot. I did like that movie a lot.
Hello. No. No.
Almost time, Rose.
Barbarian, I thought was decent. I know you didn't care for it, but I'm actually was looking forward to maybe the prequel to find out more about that dude who's like kidnapping these people and building all these fucking tunnels under this neighborhood. I thought that would make for an interesting prequel.
You have a nice day now.
Right now, if you had to ask me like what my favorite horror movie is right now, is probably Pearl. And
yeah,
I don't even
you
think
love that, Pearl.
I don't think that's a horror movie. I mean, it has some gore, it has some murder, but I wouldn't consider it a horror movie. It's just really well made and well acted.
Take it.
Mia, I never even noticed Mia Goth before. I mean, I remember she was in X.
That was great. Which, see, I like X better than Pearl.
See, I liked X, but my favorite part of X was probably the Ortega girl. What's her name?
Jenna.
I want to do a scene in the movie.
What?
Well, I'm young. And if we really are making a good, dirty movie, I don't want to just carry the equipment. I want to be in it. Oh, come on, RJ. Nobody's coming to see this film for the plot. They're coming to see tits and ass.
I never really realized that was Wednesday at the time. Yeah, she's great in that movie.
Pearl comes out, and I had no expectations for her. But Mia Goth is so good in that.
She is.
My God.
One day you'll never see me again. Farm life may be it for you, but it sure ain't for me. I'm special.
The last shot of that film, it broke me, dude. I couldn't.
It broke you?
I was sitting there, and I just lost it. I was like, He just kept the kept the thing rolling. I mean, if you've seen Pearl, don't turn it off at the end.
And you wanted to talk about it forever, and I sat on my ass forever.
If you liked your performance in Pearl, check out Infinity Pool. Again, she plays an insane person.
Yeah!
I can't really name one favorite horror movie of all time. Before I saw Pearl, it'd probably be Midsommar. But I don't even think that's a horror. It's not a horror movie to me. And I still love Midsommar.
I got some horror films that I love, but aren't necessarily scary. Or maybe they kind of were at first, but now they're more like... fascinating. I gotta throw Demons on there, dude. Umberto Bava, Mario Bava's son. It's disgusting, and there's hot babes everywhere, and it's fucking funny. There's like a guy who's kind of like a Mr. T type character.
The movie's to blame for all this.
She's right. She put on that mask and scratched herself. Get it? Because of that scratch, she became a demon.
It's a simple plot, but it's just so fucking entertaining.
What are you waiting for? Stop the movie!
Where's the projection booth?
Upstairs, next to the gallery.
Right, we'll all go up there together. If we stick together, no one gets hurt. Got it?
The original Evil Dead, of course. But I mean, to be honest with you, if I had to pick my favorite horror film of all time, it's been the same one since I was a little kid. Which is Poltergeist. And we were talking about Toby Hooper earlier. Dude, I had the craziest experience when I first saw that movie. My mom hyped Poltergeist up to me once at an A's game. She was reading like the pamphlet of what the story was about. It was like a teaser. And, you know, I was getting fucking amped. So I had been waiting for Poltergeist for a while. Remember the old Cine 3 downtown Vallejo or on Tennessee Street?
Yes.
Me and my brother were going to go see a matinee that day of Poltergeist. We were waiting in line. We got our tickets, and I could see my brother starting to get a little edgy. At the last minute, as we're walking in the theater, he's like, I can't do it. I can't do it. I'm like, what? What do you mean you can't do it? I can't. I'm going to go watch E.T. I go into Poltergeist by myself, and it was incredible. For me, I think of like maybe four or five greatest movie experiences of my life. You know, you got your Empire Strikes Back, Raiders of the Lost Ark, Pulp Fiction, or Dark Knight for a lot of people. But for me, right up there at the top is Poltergeist.
There is no death. It is only a transition to a different sphere of consciousness.
Love her speech about death and the fear of death. And how people perceive it. Because I don't know about y'all, but I want to believe in a magic. I've lost plenty of people in my life who are gone, and I want to believe that, you know, they went somewhere better, you know? And that it's just not like someone turning off a light. And I honestly believe that, you know? Mm-hmm. There's an element behind Poltergeist. There's a heart behind it, you know? And I know it's not necessarily a scary movie, per se.
Oh, I think it's definitely got some scares in it.
I think one of the things that makes it ultra creepy for us is we grew up in that type of world in California. That shit reminded me of, like, Skyway up the street from where me and John Tracy and Mark all grew up, you know?
All these movies that take place in like suburban areas are easily relatable.